Ladies and gentlemen, for one last time, I'm going to call this meeting to order. This is a regular meeting of the Board of Trustees for Springfield Township. And as is our usual custom, we begin our meeting with a pledge of allegiance, and I ask you to join us. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Mrs. Price, will you call the roll?
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Here.
Here.
Mr. DeRoro?
Here.
We always give people an opportunity to speak to the issues that are before us. If there's something on the agenda which has been passed out that you want to speak to us on prior to us voting. Not hearing anyone, I'm going to jump into the issues before us. And we have in past meetings had plenty of advanced review for the members of the board. I'm going to move to dispense with the reading of minutes and approve the minutes to date.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Next, I move to approve payment of bills and payroll as prepared by the fiscal officer subject to audit.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Next, I move to approve that all current administrative personnel, non-union employees, are at-will employees and shall be rehired beginning January 1, 2024 as at-will employees. The payroll for 2024 will commence on 12/25/2023 with a pay date of January 12, 2024, and will conclude on December 22nd, 2024 with a pay date of December
27th,
2024. Second. Roll call, yeah. Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
I don't know if there's a little feedback in the, maybe if our audiovisual people could turn it down a little bit. We'll give that a try. Next, I move to approve carryover of vacation time for non-contract and contract personnel, but only as authorized by our non-contract policy manual and union contract.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Next, I move to approve the temporary appropriations for 2024 per the attached listing, which is available to any who request it of our fiscal officer. This is per revised code 5705.38C regarding budgetary control, with appropriation measures shall be classified so as to set forth separately the amounts appropriated for each department. Our legal level of control is set as personnel services and as other per each fund. The fiscal officer will certify this resolution and forward a copy of the temporary appropriations to the Summit County Budget Commission for recording pending permanent appropriations for 2024, which will be filed by April 1, 2024. The list being attached, and as I say, is available to anyone requesting from our fiscal officer.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Next, I move to approve the attached resolution for the replacement of the HVAC system with a Bryant 1.5 ton ductless, free, mini, split for the computer servicer room.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Next, I move to approve the attached resolution authorizing expenditures from the American Rescue Plan Act funds. And Mr. Weinheimer, this has been reviewed with council, so compliance with that particular federal act.
That is correct. Yes, that is correct.
Is there a second?
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Next, I move to approve nunc pro tunc, meaning now for then, the payment to Mulch Makers of Ohio in the amount of $3,080 for the organics collection voucher program through Summit Reworks and paid from fund line 1000-110-500.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Next, I have the honor to move to appoint Brett P. Reinbold to the position of fire chief for Springfield Township to be effective February 5, 2024. This appointment contingent on the satisfactory completion of the physical examination required by the Ohio Police and Fire Disability Pension Fund, including the satisfactory completion of drug screening. The appointment will follow the terms and conditions as outlined on the attached employment agreement. I move that appointment.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
And Mrs. Chapman? No, Mr. DeLauro. You had some matters for the zoning department?
Yes. Pursuant to Ohio Revised Code 505.86, I move to declare the condition of the structures at 1213 Abington Road, also known as parcel 51-02890, to be unsafe, a nuisance, and uninhabitable, and for the demolition of the structures on the property with the total cost incurred for the abatement to be certified to the Summit County Fiscal Officer as a lien upon the parcel.
I would second that motion.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Pursuant to Ohio Revised Code 505.87, I move to declare the conditions of 2325 South Arlington Street, known as parcel 5106346, to be a nuisance property, that an order be issued to the property owners to abate the nuisances by removal of all items detailed on the zoning administrator's report within 7 days. Failing that, this board shall act to abate the nuisances by removing the refuse, junk, and debris, with the total cost incurred for the abatement to be certified to the Summit County Fiscal Officer as a lien upon the parcel.
Okay, I would second that.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Pursuant to Ohio Revised Code 505.87, I move to declare the conditions of 1064 Crestline Drive, known as parcel 51-09370, to be a nuisance property, that an order to be issued to the property owners to abate the nuisances by removal of all items detailed on the zoning administrator's report within 7 days. Failing that, this board shall act to abate the nuisances by removing the refuse, junk, and debris, with the total cost incurred for the abatement to be certified to the Summit County Fiscal Officer as a lien upon the parcel.
I would second that.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
And lastly, for this year, pursuant to Ohio Revised Code 505.87, I move to declare the conditions of 962 Abington Road, known as parcel 51-02989, to be a nuisance property, that an order be issued to the property owners to abate the nuisances by removal of all items detailed on the zoning administrator's report within 7 days. Failing that, this board shall act to abate the nuisances by removing the refuse, junk, and debris with the total cost incurred for the abatement to be certified to the Summit County Fiscal Officer as a lien upon the parcel.
I would second that.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
You have a couple matters for our road department?
Yes, I move to authorize the administrative assistant to the Board of Trustees to execute an agreement on behalf of the Board of Trustees with Enterprise Fleet Management Leasing Program for one 2024 Chevy work truck for a four-year lease agreement for no more than $1,800 per month, with a $500 purchase option at the end of the 48-month lease. This lease to be paid from Fund Line 2021-760-790.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
I move to authorize payment to Enterprise Fleet Management in the amount of $8,117 for a Steel Service Pro service body and paid from Fund Line 2031-760-790. Is that the correct fund line?
Yes, that's correct.
The one?
Different fund line.
Okay, all right.
Does that affect any item?
No.
Okay. Did we have a second?
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
And lastly, for the roads, I move to approve the participation in the 2024 Summit County Regional Pavement Maintenance Program with the Summit County Engineers Office.
I'm going to second that. I think it's nice to let the public know why we do that, Mr. Weinsheimer. I mean, in terms of our continuing effort to do the most that we can at a very reasonable cost.
That is correct. If we basically go in with Summit County and other municipalities and villages and cities, whatever, townships. They put all these bids together, which helps to get us our lowest cost. If we were to go out on our own, we would probably pay, I would guess we'd pay a few more dollars for our road program.
Yeah, and I want to really commend you for the work to try to improve the amount of mileage on the roads that we're able to cover. Over the years that I've been on the board, you've consistently tried to increase what we can do with what we've got.
That is correct.
And I think this last year was the most, and I see from your proposed budget, we're going to try to exceed that in the coming year.
Correct.
So I'm going to second the motion.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Mrs. Chapman, you have some matters for the police department.
I move to approve the purchase of a drone system in the amount of $14,367 payable to Ohio Drone Repair to be paid from Fund Line 2081-590-420-2012. The funds to make this purchase were all obtained through generous donations.
Second.
I will second that motion.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
I move to approve the payment in the amount of $5,272.89 to the City of Stowe for 2024 Metro SWAT Fair Share Bearcat purchase fee, paid from Line 2081-210-360-1028.
Yeah, I'm going to second the motion. Chief, maybe you want to say a word or two on how this advantages us to participate in this program.
Sure. We're part of the Metro SWAT team, which covers several communities from Aurora, Barberton, Boston Heights, Copley, Fairlawn, Hudson, Kent State, Macedonia, New Franklin, the list goes on. We're part of that team. They're buying a new armored vehicle this year, so each one of the communities, according to their population, pays a fair share or a portion of that purchase of that new equipment that they'll be using for the Metro SWAT team. What does it do for Springfield Township? It gives us access to a full-service SWAT team anytime that we would have a crisis or an emergency situation out here. that they would activate to our community. We also have two of our officers that train with that team regularly. It's a great resource for our police department, for our community, to be a part of this team.
Yeah, we get a lot of benefit for that amount of money.
Yes.
I commend you for the leadership in continuing this.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yeah, seconded it.
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
I move to approve the payment in the amount of $5,079.22 to Richards Garage for the replacement transmission to the 2020 Chevy Tahoe and paid from fund line 2081-210-323-0904.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
I move to approve payment in the total amount of $15,600 to Summit County Fiscal Officer for 2024 police and fire radio maintenance operations. Payment to be made in the biannual installments of $7,800 paid from fund line 2081-210-360-4200 and fund line 2191-230500-3600.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Finally, for both the fire department and the police department.
So what's the other thing? I move to approve payment in the total amount of $329,930 to South Summit Council of Governments for 2024 police and fire dispatching services. Payments to be made in four quarterly installments of $82,482.50. Paid from fund line 2081-210-360-1017 in the amount of $51,055 and fund line 2191-230500 in the amount of $31,427.50.
A comment I think can be made here is that this is a whole year's payment for the dispatch service that covers both the police department and the fire department.
Yes, sir, that's correct.
And contracting with the city of Green has saved us considerable money as opposed to the contract that we had before by contracting separately with the sheriff for the police and with Green or I can't remember the name of the consortium.
Swisscom.
Yeah, Swisscom. So we saved, and what was it that we saved going to this contract with Green?
I know it was significant savings, Mr. Young, but I don't have that in front of me. But there is there's been a benefit. They've provided a great service for us, for police and fire. There's also a benefit working with your neighbors. Now our dispatch center, rather than being in the city of Norton, which operated fine, we operate now out of the city of Green, which is right to the south of us. So along with the cost savings, our dispatch center is close, and they provide excellent service to both police and fire. And the fund lines are from both with the cost for police and fire for the year.
And we now have one dispatch center that serves both of our safety departments as opposed to two separate which has increased the communication between our safety forces.
Yes.
And you've given good leadership in this particular matter.
Thank you.
I second the motion.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Okay. Is there any matter that anyone has on a business issue to present to us? If not, I'm going to turn the chair over to Mr. DeLauro. Oh, Mrs. Chapman.
No, you're the chair.
What's she saying?
Oh, yes.
All right. I'm
going to talk. Oh, okay. All right. So, as everyone's probably well aware, this will be Dean's last meeting of this year, and of his term here as trustee. We'd like to thank you for all your dedication and hard work you put in throughout all the years. And there's a proclamation here I will read for Trustee Dean Young. Whereas we honor those who generously give their time and talents to improve their communities, and whereas Springfield Township Board of Trustees deems it necessary to highlight the accomplishments and bestow honor on township employees who are committed to excellence and consistently strive to improve our community. And whereas Trustee Dean Young is one of those people, as he has devoted 16 years of faithful service as a Springfield Township trustee. Now therefore, we the Springfield Township Board of Trustees, in appreciation of his dedication and service to the Township of Springfield and its citizens, honor Trustee Dean Young as he transitions into a new chapter of life and service. In witness thereof, we have hereunto set our hand and seal this 28th day of December 2023 by Trustee Chapman and myself.
Thank you. Thank you.
Need me scooting?
Yeah.
Joe needs to scoot down.
Okay.
All right. Thank you both. I really didn't need this, because I think serving as a trustee is a privilege, an opportunity to represent and try to do the best to continue to see that our township goes forward. When you're talking about excellence in terms of employees, I've had the privilege of working with some really good people here. And I want to say, I'm not just talking about the trustees to my right and my left, who have both really, it's been enjoyable to serve with them. Debbie Davis, who served prior, and I can go backwards in time and name some other trustees. But one thing I want people to know in the township, how fortunate they are to have some of the people that we have as employees. And I've had a good look at the work that's done here by our safety forces, the administrative staff. There really are people that are dedicated to Springfield and are doing a good job of day in and day out doing the work of the township. There were many, as some people don't know, there are many hours that these people spend that you don't see or don't know about. My girlfriend Kelly can tell you there are a lot of hours that I should have been on the farm, but I was here, and it was my privilege to be here. I wish the best to my successor, and I wish the best to the people who will continue, I know, working for the benefit of Springfield Township. That's about all I have to say. Thank you. So, do we have, I think that this concludes our official business by the Board of Trustees for the year 2023. Is there anything further needs to be said or done while we're here?
I'd like to say as a citizen, thanks for all your hours of service. You're not just, you don't just help put out fires of what our concerns are, but you're a strategic thinker. And I think that's, this township needs that. So we appreciate it. 16 years of that.
Thank you. Thank you for that. Okay, I'm going to move that we declare our business for 2023. Concluded and adjourned.
Second.
Roll call, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes.
Mr. Young?
Yes.
Mr. DeLauro?
Yes.
Okay. We're off the record.